Hi everybody, it's Kathy and welcome back to Kathy's Easy Beauty. In today's video, I'm sharing 5 best makeup products of 2021. I am doing this collab video with my friend Mel from Mel C's Makeup and Style. Mel's a fellow Canadian. She lives on the west coast of Canada and I live in Ontario, right in the middle of the country. I believe we are both the same age. I'm 52. After you've watched both of our videos, you will then have 10 best new makeup products of 2021. If you're coming over from Mel's channel, I really hope that you will click the subscribe button. I do a lot of easy everyday makeup looks, as well as I'm getting into some fashion videos. I have some fun fashion videos planned for the upcoming weeks now that the nice weather is here. So after you watch my video, please go check out Mel's video, and her video will be linked in the description box below. So I came up with 5 new makeup products to me I have discovered in 2021 and I'm absolutely loving. Now, if you have been watching me for a while, you know I typically don't get too excited over eyeshadow palettes because they're just not my thing. But I have to tell you, I found an eyeshadow palette this year and I am loving it. It is so gorgeous. I have a separate video just about it that I will link in the description box, but I'm talking about the Viseart Petite Pro Midsummer Palette. This eyeshadow is so buttery soft and luxurious. It's really hard to describe. It's really like wearing butter on your eyelids. It is gorgeous. It lasts all day. The color is just so pretty, and I love that it's a tiny palette. I'm not really into eyeshadows, and sometimes whenever I have bought bigger palettes in the past, it's kind of a little bit overwhelming. So I really like one and done eyeshadow looks. I like easy looks. This would be great for whenever we can travel again. The colors are so neutral that, you know, you can wear them every day, or say I'm going somewhere where I need like more nighttime look, you can easily amp it up and go with a more glamorous look. I really, really highly recommend this palette. I love it. And be sure to go check out my video because you'll see my first impressions and you'll see how easily it applies. And it's really breathtaking. It's really, really beautiful. My second best new makeup product so far for 2021 is a foundation, and it's by Estee Lauder. It is the Estee Lauder Futurist Hydra Rescue Moisturizing Makeup with an SPF of 45, and I wear it in the shade Fresco, which is 2C3. I used to wear in the double wear, the color was Pebble, but I find that this is a much better color match for me. I have a separate video where you can see me applying it. It's really, really nice. I love that it's in a tube. It has a pump, which is great. And I would say that the price is comparable to other brands that are in the same kind of pump container. It's my favorite. Comparing it to the CC cream by IT Cosmetics, I prefer this one. I think that the color just looks better on me. It's more natural, whereas sometimes the CC cream on me anyways, it can look a little orange after a few hours. I love that this is so lightweight. Like, it just feels like I have nothing on my skin. It doesn't accentuate my pores. I have large pores on my cheeks and my nose. It doesn't accentuate it at all. Like I said, the color is beautiful. It's literally like just putting it on my skin. It just blends in beautifully. So I did a really good job picking the color online, and I like that it's lightweight, and I did do a wear test and it lasted a good 8 hours for me, and that was with wearing a primer underneath and powder on top. And that's probably the longest that I would expect a foundation to work, because I work from home, so I'm not looking for, like, you know, foundations that last me 12 hours or more. Really love this. It has a light scent, but it's not overpowering. And you don't smell it at all after you have applied the product. My favorite way of applying it, I've tried both a brush and the beauty blender, and I like putting it on with just a damp beauty blender. I'll just run my beauty blender under the tap and then wring out all the water. And for me, that's the best way that I find most foundations apply on my skin. Sometimes with a brush, I don't know, it just goes on a little too heavy or too cakey looking. So I'm loving this foundation. And I do like that it has an SPF in it, because somebody that really doesn't like wearing a separate sunscreen on their face, I'm glad that I found a product that I can wear every day and it will protect me somewhat from the sun. Oh my goodness, my next favorite product, again, I have a separate video about it. It's the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Vanish Color Corrector. This is in the shade 1, which is fair. It's the lightest color. Go check out my first impressions video. I'll link a card, and I will link a card for my video that I did separately just on this. I never knew what the difference really was about a color corrector, and I explained that in that video. But basically, a color corrector is used whenever you want to hide like dark circles or bruises or, you know, dark spots you just want covered. I wear this product by itself. Most days I don't wear makeup, but I will put this on because I find as I'm aging, I'm losing some of the fat deposits under the eyes. So that creates shadows, which creates dark circles. And this does a great job of concealing those. I prefer this over a concealer. I've tried several different companies' concealers, and actually I could actually live with just owning this product and not having to use a concealer. Now, some of you have asked me, does it do a good job like covering red spots? It does an okay job, but if you want the red spot totally gone, you're still gonna have to use a concealer for those sort of things. But for me, my issue was I had a blue, like dark circles women get as we age. This does a really great job, but I do want to mention one thing. The longer that I have been using it, I have noticed that it does get a little bit dry under the eyes, like maybe after about 6 or 7 hours. So I just wanted to bring that to your attention. Like I said, this is the only color corrector that I've ever used. I do have oily skin. My skin's been giving me an issue this year, and I'm hoping it changes as summer comes, but I guess it's hormonal and my skin is getting a little drier as I age. So I have noticed that the longer that I have used that, a little bit of dryness does show up under the eye. I think unless somebody, you know, had a magnifying glass and was super close to you and looking for the issue, it would show up, but just, you know, for day-to-day things, I think that it's perfectly fine. Another product that I recently bought, well, I had used it before in the past, but I needed to replenish mine, and it's by Charlotte Tilbury, and it's her Eyes to Mesmerize Pot Eyeshadow. This is in the color Champagne. I'm wearing it today. It's just a nice, light color for the summer. I like one and done, and especially in the summer because it gets so darn humid here. I don't feel like, you know, pulling out a palette and doing a whole lot of time on makeup. So I just wanted to mention this. She has several other colors, and I'm actually thinking of getting the Pink Jewel one. I think it's from the Pillow Talk line, but I was just reading on Sephora that some of the reviews aren't that great because they were saying that the Pillow Talk pot of a cream shadow, it really dries out easily. I haven't really had an issue. Like I said, this is my second pot of this. Before I had the rose gold one and it never really dried out on me. So I just wanted to mention that. I do like these, and if you're like me, if you like a one and done type of an eyeshadow look, you might like this. Now something that, it's not really a makeup product, but I have to mention it because I use this every day and I've used it now for years. It's by Caudalie and it's their grape water. I love this stuff. I squirt my face every night before I get into bed, or anytime my skin is feeling a little tight or dry. This stuff is great. It has a nice mist. You can use it as also a setting spray. I've read people use it for setting spray for setting your makeup. I like it just to add more hydration into my skin. It's great for redness. I also suffer with rosacea, but my rosacea seems to be controlled with the skincare that I've been using. But this is also helps redness and dryness, and I can tell you 110% it does help with the dryness, and I love this stuff. This is a small size because the large size wasn't available when I went to reorder it. So whenever I can get a large one, I'm gonna grab it. But I love this stuff, and I just wanted to mention that to you as well. And I'm throwing in a bonus skincare item because my jam is skincare. I love skincare, love talking about skincare. I'm horrible at wearing sunscreen on my face. I just don't like doing it. I hate it. It's one more product to slap on my face. And as somebody that has had oily skin all of her life, I just don't like that feeling of stuff on my face. And I certainly don't like feeling like I have an oil slick, which sometimes happens when you put sunscreen on. But it's so important to wear sunscreen, and especially if you're using tretinoin or Retin-A, because you want to protect the new skin that's coming out. So I found this product about 6 months ago and I'm wearing it today. I wear it every day faithfully. It's by Elta MD. It's a daily moisturizer. This is a moisturizer that I use in the morning. And in Canada, it has an SPF of 40, but I believe in the US, the SPF is 45. I will link a few places below in the description box if you want more information to check it out. But one pump gives a generous size amount. It's almost like a small grape, and that does my whole face and my neck. Now, there is a bit of a white cast, so I take my time applying it. And if you take your time applying it, the whiteness just disappears. My face does not feel oily, it's not tacky, and I love that this is a one and done product because, like I said, most days I don't wear makeup, so I go around with this on and I know that I'm protected. Now, of course, if I was, you know, working out outside or swimming or whatever, I would have to apply it every 2 or 3 hours, but I just wanted to mention this because if you're like me and you hate putting a separate sunscreen on your face, this might be something that you might be interested in. And I also wanted to mention that it comes in a tinted formula. So when this is done, I might try the tinted version just to see what it's like. So I hope that you've enjoyed seeing my 5 best makeup products so far for 2021. If you're new here, I would really love it if you subscribe to my channel for more easy everyday beauty looks. And be sure to go check out my friend Mel at Mel C Makeup and Style. And her video, like I said earlier, will be linked below in the description box. It was great working with you again, Mel. If you'd also like to follow me on Instagram, you can follow me there. I will put all of my social media links in the description box. And if you would like to follow me on the Like to Know It app, that would be great as well. I post daily outfit looks on there with all of the clothing information is linked through the app. Thank you so much for spending time with me today. I appreciate your time and I hope that you have a wonderful day, and I will see you very soon in my next video. Take care. Bye.